Lecture 14, Limitations of Reality. In this lecture, we will explore whether children can understand that our wishes cannot be directly implemented into reality. We will examine at what age the children start to realize that a person's subjective world is private and cannot be accessed directly by other people. Finally, we will find out when the children begin to understand that having the boundary between inner and outer worlds is necessary for human existence. The aims of the dialogues were to examine whether the children are able to understand. First, the limitations that everyday reality places upon thinking and the activity of the individual, the impossibility of the immediate accomplishment of human wishes and the inaccessibility of another person's thoughts for direct observation, and second, the positive role that these limitations play in making human existence possible. Question 1. Tell me, if you wished hard for the microphone in my hand to turn into a sparrow, would it turn into a sparrow? Why? Question 2. And if you wished for a jar of sweets to appear in front of you, would it appear? Why? Question 3. And if you wanted to know everything that I am now thinking, without actually asking me any questions, could you find out? Why? Question 4. And what about me? Can I learn what you are now thinking right now? And in what way can a person learn about what another person is thinking? Question 5. Tell me, if you had a magic wand that could make all your wishes possible, what would you ask it to do for you? Question 6. Would you like to live in a world where the wishes of everyone immediately become reality? Why? Question 7. Would you like to live in a world in which all wishes of all people in the world would immediately become reality? Why? Question 8. Would you like to live in a world where all of your dreams immediately come true? Why? Question 9. If the answers are positive, tell me, do you have only good wishes and no bad wishes, or you may have bad wishes too? Question 10. Tell me, are there only good people in the world, or there are also bad ones? Question 11. So, would you like to live in a world in which all your wishes or those of other people immediately become reality? Question 12. And what about a world in which people are able to see each other's thoughts directly without even asking one another? Would you like to live in such a world? Why? Question 13. Do you sometimes have thoughts that you would not like to share with other people? Question 14. And what about other people? Do they sometimes have thoughts that they would prefer to keep to themselves? Question 15. So, would you like to live in a world in which people were able to see each other's thoughts? Question 16. Do you always have nice dreams, or you have frightening dreams as well? Question 17. So, would you like to live in a world in which all your dreams immediately become reality? Results. All children were completely aware of the boundary existing between their wishes and everyday reality by denying the possibility for their wishes to immediately become reality. Questions 1 and 2. Most children thought that direct access to other people's thoughts was impossible. Questions 3 and 4. Some of the children simply denied such a possibility. Others referred to it as magic or telepathy, which are impossible in real life. Almost all the preschoolers and a large number of school children wouldn't have minded living in a world in which all their wishes immediately become reality. However, many school children refused to live in such a world. One major reason was the children's fear that their negative wishes would also become reality. For example, one child says, "No, I would not like to live in such a world, because, for instance, I can think of something bad and it would appear." And another child says, "No, because if I want something, I would not be able to stop the wish, and this wish could be a bad, wrong wish." About half of the preschoolers And all the school children refused to live in a world in which people could see each other's thoughts. Some did this for moral reasons. For instance, one child says, well, it would be like peeping through a keyhole in the door. Others because they wanted to keep their own thoughts secret. For instance, the child says, I have all sorts of thoughts. It is no good if everyone knows about them.
As can be seen from this graph, a considerable part of 5 to 9 year olds denied that they can have bad wishes along with the good ones. But almost all of the children acknowledge that other people can have bad wishes. Finally, most children are aware that they have thoughts that they would not like to share with other people.
Conclusions. Younger children, 5 to 9 years of age, could realize the existence of the boundaries that separate our thoughts and wishes from reality, but were unable to appreciate the positive role that such boundaries play in human life. They viewed these boundaries as the obstacles to overcome, rather than the guardians that make reality safe from our potentially dangerous thoughts. It is only by the age of 7-9 years that the majority of children begin to realize the positive role of the boundaries between the mind and reality. Asking children the auxiliary questions, questions 9, 10, 13, and 16, help many of the children to realize that their inner world and that of other people as well is complex and can contain bad wishes along with the good ones. This realization increased the number of children who refused to live in a world in which all wishes immediately come true. And general conclusions on section 2, lectures 8 to 14. Children aged 5 to 13 years showed a wide spectrum of judgments about the human being. At one end of this spectrum, we can see complex and intellectually advanced judgments, such as the understanding that a young infant can assess distances to objects and understand spatial perspective. The understanding of unconscious processes, such as the effect of needs on dreams and perceptions. At the other end of this spectrum are the judgments which are naive and show the lack of psychological experience in our participants, such as believing that a newborn baby knows names of objects and even can use those objects. Thinking that a young infant knows moral rules and is able to observe those rules. Believing in that an animal can have moral feelings. Thinking that an inanimate object can feel pain. Interestingly, both advanced and naive judgments could be made by the same child. The most significant shift in children's judgments about the human being takes place at the age between 6 and 9 years. Thanks for attending this course.